Well, I landed in Web3 kind of like 6 years ago. I came to Polkadot when the parity hack happened, when there was a multisig problem that locked $92 million on Ethereum. And we tried to communicate with Ethereum to get those funds unlocked, but the lack of governance within Ethereum didn't allow this to proceed because someone decided not to. It was a community vote, but because these votes are not enacted in the right way, after that happened, I started to be interested more into systems that could bring true governance, enacted governance on chain, so it could not be changed. In that way, community votes, platform-wide votes are the decision point, and no one can override that. That's why I brought into Polkadot and other two different blockchains that were trying to do the same, but sadly they haven't reached the point that we have in Polkadot. So that's why I'm here, really. Polkadot community is a close community, yeah? If we have to go to demographics, it's a community that is composed of people from anywhere. I feel that each one of us have the capacity to change the future. We just don't know how. Our decisions change with the wind. We need a common platform that will allow truth and consensus to prevail over everything. And that's what Polkadot brings into the table. I think these systems can evolve to bring, to make the internet what it was supposed to be. This is where I see Polkadot years from now, being the base of the internet. We could basically run the internet on this trust layer, keeping privacy, security, and everything attached to it. Basically, keeping basic human rights in the forefront of using the platform, not the other way around.